Hi, I'm Ryan. I work in the media industry and I've lived in China for almost 4 years now. 2021 marks the 100th anniversary of the founding of the Communist Party of China. And during those 100 years, its members have grown from a few dozen to over 95 million strong. Living in China, some of my friends and colleagues are party members. Now you might be curious, what exactly are these people like? So to help you get a better understanding, I've invited other foreigners who also live in China to go and visit young party members through various careers in an attempt to paint a clearer picture by better getting to know their life and their work. We hope to discover who these people really are. And I personally hope that these experiences help foreigners in China and abroad better understand this country and its people.
I'm Daniela. I'm from Brazil. In January of this year, looked like the pandemic was just about to return when some new local cases popped up in Shanghai. But that crisis was over and the people could even take off their masks after a week. As a foreigner, I wonder what exactly is the force that made the pandemic almost under control in China. Today, I'm going to visit Dr. Chen Yanfan. She's an anti-pandemic hero. So let's find out what Dr. Chen and her team did to prevent Shanghai people from panic and fear, and what kind of great force supports her to always be the pioneer and complete the difficult task of prevention and control of disease in the first place.
Hi,
Dr. Chen.
Hi,
I'm Jenny.
你好，我是陈远芳，我来自上海市徐汇区疾病预防控制中心。我的工作呢是进行流行病学调查，大多数的时间呢是和病例打交道，也和密切接触者打交道。哇
，Ultraman！对，他们两个都特别喜欢奥特曼拯救世界，然后今天也是难得，我就把他们带出来玩一下。 等下我把他们送到学习班，然后我回单位一个。你跟我一起吧。啊，好好好。那我们准备一下。啊，好了。
The first time I saw Dr. Chen, she was quite different from all the images I thought of an anti-pandemic hero. She smiles a lot and sounds very tender. She told me that the epidemic prevention and control work in Shanghai has entered to a normalized stage, and most of their lives and work has returned to a relatively stable period. Following her steps, the first time I walked into the Shuihui Disease Control Warehouse in Shanghai, I was immediately attracted by the rows of blue bags.
Dr. Chen, what are all those blue bags?
这个吗？是的，我们这个就是流调的补充包。比如说，现在如果疫情真发生了的话，根本就不可能有时间准备，对吗？ 我们可以把它就是从下到上穿成二级防护。哇，对对对，所以你看拿起来就走，很方便。见周到，描述的很精准啊，都很不错。As
an old saying goes, prevention is better than cure. In college, Dr. Chen chose preventive medicine, which she also considered as a major that's capable to save lives on a larger scale.
I thought the party member I was going to meet was a superhero. 但是 superhero 也是我们公司吗？
superhero 也是工作人员。对于我们来讲，我们其实是防止病毒扩散的医生。我们流调的工作反而要比绣花针还要细。发生的病例，他接触了哪些人？他做了哪些事情？他在做这些事情当中又去接触了哪些人？
Since an employee of the hospital was diagnosed with the coronavirus, Dr. Chen's team checked over 400 surveillance videos for the past 6 days, night and day.
I really admire you.
这个桌面有点乱，不好意思。这个照片啊。这个照片是我们整个团队的一个合影。对，我的脸藏在这个文件后面。你说到这个，我想起来，我给你找找看，有没有其他的照片啊。
美丽，
很美丽是吗？
是的 ，very beautiful。
这个是疫情之前一个月，当时因为有一个案子破不掉，所以我们很多的时候都是在通宵。你像我的床。这是我的床、wow. 来不及就睡在这边、
oh, 你也是我的 superhero、oh, 真的
过奖过奖嗯，在梅园中学有一个演练你要不要跟我去看一下、oh,
可以啊
那我们走
好
来同学们我们来入校测体温来注意脚下一米线排成一队列、啊、
The schools were closed during the peak of the coronavirus outbreak but in order to not affect teaching too muchThe rate of Chinese children returning to school was very high, and all of this was based on a complete and coordinated system of prevention and control.
学校、养老院、幼儿园等等，它都属于集体机构。在这样一个机构里边呢，人员是比较密集的。同时，在学校里边产生这样的疫情，它的社会影响也是非常大的。
是上幼儿园的还是？五岁
啊，
在
啊，你们好。
他们在做什么？
他们在进行流行病学调查，所有的登记名单上面，它会有学生的电话号码，然后我们有这个专门的流调手机，打过去之后，然后就会问一些，比方说你发病时间呢、啊，在哪里发病的。
I thought the drill was just an experiment, but every time I saw Dr. Chen, she was quite opposite and very serious most of the time.
是整个教室的喷洒。
对，
我们调查整个的颗粒度是非常细的，并且整个的时间线上不能够留有任何的空白，从这一秒到下一秒当中一定要是连接的，这样这一条线才是一个完整的闭环。
After leaving the school, Dr. Chen said she would take me to a place free from worry. I thought we were going to climb a mountain or something. But our car kept driving through the city until we finally arrived at the Urban Operations Management Center in Shanghai, Shuhui.
这里就是城市运行的大脑。走吧。
Really nice. Yeah.
As soon as I walked through the door, the atmosphere of technology was overwhelming. I was thrilled about what we were going to see.
Wow. Oh my, wow, that's so impressive.
其实在一起疫情的背后呢，有着非常多非常多繁琐的数据，也折射出来一个问题，就是说我们可能对于这个大数据的量的处理还是有着一定的瓶颈。应该说是在党和政府的带领下，我们各个部门集结了最优秀的人马，花了非常非常短的时间，我们开发出了一套有着这个智慧功能的系统。
With all this technology equipment, what is the kind of improvement that you can see in your daily work?
数据量很大，然后我们要处理的工作很多，实际上会一定程度上影响到我们的工作效率。那个时候我们所有的这些人包括后面的这些人几乎每天都是
对他们基本上都是凌晨三点凌晨四点才能够睡觉
对对对我们的床都在办公室里是的是的
你们很辛苦
啊我觉得做疾控呢其实最重要的三个字叫先进性我想就是因为这个也有了我们徐汇区的这个承运中心的大屏其实也是体现的是党和政府的先进性和前瞻性正是因为有着这种未雨绸缪提前计划用科技的手段去辅助防疫才能够让我们大多数的病例发现的时候我们要做的工作也不会乱也不会错
After getting along with Dr. Chen for a day I was really sorry that I could not experience the moment when she was fighting against the virus But however,I actually felt a kind of shining glimmer of the CDC worker who returned to be ordinary. She's not a virus detective. She's Chen Yanfan.
What a day. You are a mother, a wife, a doctor. I really admire you.
其实我们都是普通人、嗯、我们也有脆弱的灵魂、
嗯、的
我们也不是每天都是像你说的 superhero 嗯，实际上整个疫情开始之后这些角色都通通让位给工作了那家里人其实也挺支持我的先生啊我的婆婆啊他们都主动的把这个照顾孩子的任务啊承担了过去 那每次回去的时候我都很想抱抱他们，一开门我就会说哦等一下，让他们把孩子先拦起来，然后我自己去换衣服啊，去这个清洗啊，然后自己觉得说 OK 我现在是安全的，我再去抱他们。然后就会觉得说可能更加珍惜，会更加珍惜他。
Your story is very touching and so inspiring.
也没有了，其实大家都是这样。
Actually, I also have other question. How do you see the connection in between your work and the Communist Party?
从入党的那一天开始，我觉得我的责任心，我的使命感，它驱使我前进，不断地催我奋进。比方说我们在流调的过程中，那因为大量的这个问答，那我们也会有疲惫的时候，那每当这个时候呢，可能有一些小的问题，我们会开小差。那到这个时候，我觉得我的党员的身份会提醒我说，你不可以这样，让我把这个事情做到尽善尽美。所以我认为在我的成长过程中，入党这件事情对我来说是意义重大的。当我们在面临一些一线的任务，当一些人可以提供给你选择的时候，我觉得党员的选择永远都是说我要冲在最前面，别人不做的我来做，别人觉得害怕的我要去承担，我们就这样默默地做挺好的。
太累了。
妈咪，哎，完课了。
哇，这是你今天画的。哇
，That's so beautiful. That's really nice. I love it.
画的这是
奥特曼打败病毒。
哦，对，这个是新冠病毒。
That's really so cool.
这个奥特曼。